Hello guys, this is your reading for September. This is for Virgo, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, and Jupiter signs. Hope everybody is doing well today. Let's see what messages we get for you guys for love in the month of September. Virgo, please show me messages for Virgo. What's going on with Virgo and love for September? Right now you guys are feeling rather blissful. There is a family situation here. I feel like maybe there's two adult children involved in this situation. And these children may not be shared between the two of you. I feel like both of you may have an adult child or an older child, like a teenager or something for some of you. And you guys are trying to like blend, I feel like, an extended family for some of you. What's crossing Virgo? This is Piscean energy here with the Ten of Cups. The Knight of Cups. For some of you, or for others of you rather, there's a situation where you guys have ended a relationship and now you are contemplating like dating again, or you guys are still in a relationship but kind of looking outside of the relationship for other stimulation for some of you, okay? A lot of water here. What is the underlying issue for Virgos? Eight of Swords. There's a lot of things that have gone on in the past that you feel like you just cannot get over. Feeling trapped in your own thoughts, just constantly thinking about things over and over and over again, not able to really let it go, okay? And then maybe why some of you are seeking, you know, an outside stimulation, but still remaining in a situation here. In recent past. Three of Pentacles. And very recently, you've decided that you just want to, you want to compromise in a situation. You also want to work with other people. Is what this is. So for some of you, you are definitely still in a situation. I feel like that situation provides some semblance of stability and contentment, but there's still things that you cannot get past. You almost feel trapped in this relationship. It provides some sense of security for you, I feel. And that's why you stay there, but at the same time, it's almost like there's too much that has gone on. There's too much water under the bridge, and you're needing something else to take your mind off of the worries that that you have. So and I don't feel like whoever this is that you are currently with, they really don't know that you guys are stepping out or thinking about stepping out. They don't know that. Because I feel like, you know, there's been forgiveness here. But this person really just does not know. I feel that there's a lot of things that still weigh very heavily on you guys, okay? Crying thoughts for Virgo. Crying thoughts for Virgo. Eight of Wands. You want to make a change. You definitely want to make a change. There's something that you're wanting to end, okay? You're wanting to wrap up this cycle, these negative thoughts that just keep resurfacing, ruminating thoughts that just like, I mean, you know, it just kind of overpowers you. You want to move forward. You want to get past this. And that's like in your subconscious, basically, and your conscious mind. It's getting out. Stop thinking about this. This is what you want to do. You want to see some change in your situation so you can move forward. You want forward movement. What's coming in for Virgos? Two of Pentacles. This is you guys prioritizing. You've got a lot of things on your plate, and I feel like you're trying to handle more than one situation here. I feel like there's something that's throwing you off though, because you are trying to maintain, you know, different things right now. And there's a fine line in like really balancing and tipping over too much to one side. So you're having to try to like, you know, keep every situation in check so one thing doesn't spill over onto the other, if you know what I'm saying. Okay, Capricorn energy there and here. So there could be a situation where one person or one situation is getting more attention than the other in the situation, okay? How is Virgo viewing the situation? How is Virgo viewing the situation? Six of Swords. There's somebody that you want to work things out with. And I definitely feel like it is the person that is providing the stability for you that you're having a hard time walking away from. The only reason why I feel like you guys are, you know, wanting to or are stepping out is because there's been a lot of different things that have happened in the past that you cannot get away from. But you definitely want to, you know, talk your way through these issues so you can move on. You just want to move on. And I kind of feel like there's somebody here that has not allowed you to completely voice how you feel and how you've been hurt and, you know, and kind of force you just to kind of keep quiet. In turn, basically is forcing you to not really stay there, but be quiet while you're with them, but stepping out so you can make some noise, you know. So then we have the Sun on the bottom of the deck. I feel like you guys, your ego is at play here. And I don't know whether this person, it's almost like you're putting on a show. You're putting on a show and you really aren't letting this person know just how much you are bothered by certain things. What is the influence here for Virgo? What is the influence here for Virgo? King of Wands. You're not really trying to make a choice. On the outside, it looks like everything is okay to the person that you're with and to people in general. You know, you look like you're all put together. But I'm getting the sense that you guys are angry. I'm also getting for some of you that somebody is turning a blind eye to some things that you're doing. Could definitely be an Aries, Leo, or a Sagittarius individual for some of you. this person may also have the kind of temperament that does not allow for you to really express yourself. Hopes or fears for Virgo? Hopes or fears for Virgo? The moon. That you will be able to see things clearly. Your hope is to see things clearly, to get things in check, that certain things will be revealed to you, that you will know what to do. You're tired of like being on this emotional roller coaster. But I think you hold things in. I think that you keep this exterior of yourself where people really don't know what's going on with you. You really want to, you know, really figure out what it is that you want, what it is that you need, what it is that you want to do. And then the Wheel of Fortune just fell right here on top of the Eight of Swords here. A change is coming. You will be relieved of all the ruminating thoughts, feeling trapped in your own thoughts. That's coming to an end. That's coming to an end for you guys here. It's getting ready to turn in your favor. What you've been going through in this situation, it was really for you to learn a lesson. Once you learn that lesson, you guys will come out of this mental prison. You will be able to move forward. Release yourself. Most definitely. What's the outcome for Virgos? Outcome for Virgos. Nine of Cups. What did I tell you? Nine of Cups. This is you guys being single, though. Okay? This is you enjoying your life. This is breaking up for many of you. And dating again. Or just doing things that you like to do. If this person has done something that you can't get past, and you feel like you can never get past it, I see you moving on here. Just as soon as you realize that you can't get past it, this was a karmic cycle for you. Piscean, Sagittarius energy. And just letting it end, because you're wanting to. You're wanting it to end here. I see you guys speaking your peace, prioritizing yourself, figuring out what it is that you really want, and having your wishes granted. But nines are single energy, so for a lot of you, I see you guys being single. Could definitely be a Sagittarius, Pisces strongly. Very strongly for a lot of you. Capricorn is here. Aquarius is here. Gemini is here. Could be any energy, any sign. But yeah, so that's what I have for you guys, and I'll be speaking with you soon. Bye now.